We will discuss about the relation between the escape velocity and the projection velocity. So what is the projection velocity? This is the velocity imparted to the body when it is thrown vertically upward. So this will lead to how much distance, how much height, that we have to find it. The velocity required to reach at desired height from earth. Is called projection velocity. Projection velocity. The velocity required to reach एट डिजायर्ड हाइट, मतलब हम वस्तु को कितनी ऊंचाई तक पहुंचाना चाहते हैं। मान लो कि हम उसको अर्थ की रेडियस के बराबर ऊंचाई पर पहुंचाना चाहते हैं, या उससे कम ऊंचाई पर पहुंचाना चाहते हैं, या उससे ज्यादा ऊंचाई पर पहुंचाना चाहते हैं, तो हाउ मच स्पीड इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द बॉडी, दैट इज कॉल्ड द प्रोजेक्शन वेलोसिटी। So, मान लीजिए कि यहां पर ये अर्थ है, दिस इज द अर्थ, ये सेंटर है, ये इसकी रेडियस है, दिस इज नॉट रेडियस, द बॉडी इज प्रोजेक्टेड फ्रॉम हियर, दिस इज थ्रोन विद सम वेलोसिटी v, एंड लेट इट रीचेस टू द पॉइंट हियर, सो दिस इज नॉट point P, and let this is now height h, this height is h, so here the velocity is equal to v, here the final velocity is equal to 0, so this will reach at this point, so at point P the final velocity is equal to 0, so let this will be known by P. P यहाँ पर भी दे दिया है। This is now O. This is now suppose point A. A A A A A A तो यहाँ पर ले लो और B यहाँ पर ले लो। Right. Let VP equal to projection velocity. Projection velocity. And the radius of Earth is R and its mass is to be M. So the body is projected from the point A and the body reaches at point B. So here this is the final velocity, this is equal to 0 h this is the maximum height So again we will elaborate the law of conservation of energy. Total energy at point A, now this E1 equal to half m Vp square minus Gmm upon R. Now total energy at point B. This E2 is equal to, now here final velocity is equal to 0, so half n is now 0 minus, this is now your Gmm upon R plus H. Small m the mass of the body. So now this is equal to minus Gmm upon R plus H. This is E2. Applying the law of conservation of energy. Applying the law of conservation of energy. What we have? This E1 is equal to E2. So this is now your half mVp square minus Gmm upon R equal to minus Gmm upon R plus H. So this M will cancel from R. So we will have this Vp square is equal to 2Gm into, this is now your 1 upon R minus 1 upon R plus H. So this is now your 2Gm and this is now equal to this R because this is now H into H upon R into R plus H. So now we have Vp square is equal to Ve square into H upon R plus H, where this Ve is equal to square root of 2Gm upon R. This is now SK cross. SK cross. So now we have this Vp is equal to Ve into square root of H upon R plus H. This is now required relationship. Or this Vp is equal to Ve into square root of 1 upon, this is now your 1 plus R upon H. So now you can see from here that what must be the projection velocity so that the body could reach at a certain height. So for special cases, now what we have that this number one, when h equal to 0, h equal to 0, this is now infinity, so this is now infinity, so this is now 0, so this vp is equal to 0. Now for number 2, when h equal to r by 3, then you can see that this vp is equal to ve upon 2. It means that if the brush is projected with half of the that escape velocity, then it will reach to one third of the radius of the earth. Or this will be equal to 11.2. So this is now 11.5. 5. Then this is now 5.8 kilometer per second. And now third, when h equal to r by 2, then this vp will be equal to how much? R by 2, h equal to r by 2, r upon 2, so this is now 3, so vp upon root 3. H equal to r upon 2, r, so 2 will be here, 2 1 1 3, so this is now v upon root 3. And now number 4, when h equal to r, then this vp is equal to how much? This is now 1, then this is now ve upon root 2. Ve upon root 2. And fifth, when h equal to infinity, h equal to infinity, then this is now 0. So this is now 1. So vp equal to ve. Vp equal to ve. So these are the projection velocities when the body is thrown to some height. So then you can see that when the body is to be thrown to reach at the infinity, or this is away from the out of the gravitational field, then the projection velocity must be equal to the escape velocity of the body. So these are the escape velocity, projection velocities, and the relation with that of the escape velocity. So this is with this formula you can find when h is given, you can find this vp, and if they suppose this vp is given, you can find the h. The reverse will happen to this one. So as the height increases, the vp also increases. Hence, projection velocity increases. So this is about the escape velocity and the projection velocity. So thank you very much.